Now, what do you think is really, what's the biggest hindrance in the Philippines? Because you know what's interesting? Ireland, which is predominantly Catholic, right? And extremely,
Yes.
I mean, Ireland has already legalized divorce. So there are only two, I wouldn't say countries per se, but in the world, the Philippines and the Vatican City. Imagine it's
Yes.
the Vatican. In effect, tayo na lang ang nag-iisang sovereign nation na hindi pa legal ang divorce. Ireland, which is predominantly Catholic, has legalized it. What is stopping us? What do you believe is it?
Well, siguro marami kasi sa atin dito. To be honest with you, medyo malakas pa rin ang influence ng Roman Catholic Church, no?
Oo. But
But
it's
you
isn't
know.
it the same in Ireland? I mean, Ireland is predominantly Catholic, and yet the lawmakers were able to pass divorce. I mean,
Well,
there
I do not
was
know about
support for
I do
divorce in
not
the surveys.
But we are more traditional. Mas traditional tayo eh. So, in fact, sa atin, mas, in fairness naman sa mga Pilipino, mas respectful tayo, traditional, we adhere to our customs. So, yun talaga yung ano, and what, more than, gaano na po katagal ang Katoliko dito sa atin? More than 300, 400 years. So, medyo malalim yung pagkakabaon po sa atin. But you know, Karen, as a legislator kasi ako I do not look at it that way, no. I do not vote based on my religion. You have to be you have to you always have to consider what is just and what will benefit for the Filipino people because ako lack of option I believe is a form of poverty, Karen.
Very good.
So
I like that. That's a very good point.
everyone deserves to be happy, Karen. And I believe if we are going to curtail the right of our people, this is not mandatory, Karen. Baka akala ng mga
Oo
kababayan
nga.
natin na
Oo.
once this is passed, eh, obligado ka na mag-divorce. No. Hindi po ito mandatory. This is just an option. If you're happy with your family, I'm happy for you. You don't have to file a petition for divorce. What about those who are not? What about those who are living in misery? Karen, the divorce law is not an enemy. You have to remember that. The divorce law is a form of relief given by the state to the people who are suffering from marital abuse and oppression. Yan po yan eh.
And frankly, not only that, because in most marriages, I mean, this is all over the world, the one who benefits from divorce, if needed, is really the woman. Because in an abusive marriage, it is the woman who loses her rights. If divorce is legalized, you empower the woman, the mother. But then, how do you feel that you have lawmakers who actually speak this way? Nako, ang saya ng pamilya ko. Hindi ko kailangan ng divorce. Nako, I'm happy in my marriage. Right? They make it about them.
Well, if
That's
you
the
are
kind
happy with
of
your family,
thinking,
we're
huh?
happy for
That's
you.
the kind of thinking that some lawmakers have. It's about them.
Karen, let me ask you one question. How do you define family? Diba? Family is what? Respect, joy, love, protection. For me, that is how I define family. Now, if one lacks respect in family, masaya ka pa ba? Ginugulpi ka? And lahat ng babae po deserves to be respected.
Okay, if the divorce becomes law, now we know that this is meant to benefit the poorest of the poor, ang mga pinakamahihirap na kababaihan who cannot afford a fancy lawyer or go to pau, walang oras. How simple, I don't want to use the word simple, But how accessible would it be for women to be able to actually, it gives them more rights. This gives them a voice. What is the process? Do they go to a family court? Is it one court? Is there a lawyer assigned to the court? How many days is this?
Karen, we have, under the divorce law, we have this so-called court-assisted petitioner. Mm-hmm. So yung court-assisted petitioner, ang definition po nito, those who are with the property of less than 2.5 million pesos. So pag ang property mo, whether real or personal property, is worth 2.5 million pesos, you will be given free legal assistance by the court. Mm-hmm. Now, how do we go about it? Kung pwede po to, pag nag-apply ka at na-aprubahan ka, so even pagpa-file mo po ng petition for absolute divorce is free of charge. And even if there is a need for the psychiatrist or kung sino mang mga expert witness dyan, there is the DSWD, Department of Social Welfare and Development, who will assist you into this. So lahat dito po sa absolute divorce bill, kinonsider po yan to make it easier, to make it less cheaper, and to make it more affordable, to especially to those people who are in dire need.
Mm-mm. All right. So on that note, I think at the end of the day, this is already the litmus test, because it's the first time the absolute divorce bill has actually passed the lower house. And when you think of it in our history, what's interesting is during the American colonial period, the Philippines had divorce. It was Act 2710. It became a law in 1917. It was repealed and expanded during the Japanese period in 1943. Then in 1950, it diminished and just allowed legal separation. But technically speaking, there was divorce in the Philippines in the early 1900s. Mm-mm. All right. Siguro ang huling tanong ko na lang, Representative, the president's voice will be powerful on this one. He's not speaking about it. He's been silent when it comes to divorce. May panawagan po ba kayo sa Pangulo?
Well, sa akin po, ang panawagan ko po sa Pangulo, sana po, tignan po niya, he should be a voice, he should be a leader, not only of a certain sector. He is a leader of the Filipino people. And definitely, everyone deserves to be happy. Sana po, tignan din po niya ang mas nakararami.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, Representative Joel Chua. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.